disclose to me the location of the Ninja Turtles.
I never thought I'd meet anybody like you!
Oh, come on, Chi-Chi, can't we train some more? Oh, man!
So weird, I'm not used to playing Goku with a camera on me.
My name is Sean Schemmel, and I'm a professional voice actor. And for the last 25 years, I've been providing voices for animation, anime, video games, pretty much in that field. I've done some commercial voiceover, but the vast majority of my work is in cartoons and animation. I'm a character voice actor. If you want to be a professional and you want to put your best foot forward and you want to put on the best vocal tuxedo you can, in my opinion, there's no other choice than Rupert Neve Designs gear. I read all Rupert's white papers, and he's having to do a very clever trick. And I've spent a lot of time analyzing this because I felt like there were so many misnomers used for describing sound, like clean pres are better and fast transients. And what I figured out is basically when you've got a waveform, you've got the human voice, you're basically taking a waveform, it's gonna vibrate a mylar gold sputtered piece of film like an eardrum, and you've got to send that through an electrical signal, and when it comes out speakers, how close can it feel like the conversation you and I are having right here? And Rupert Neve figured that out. The emotional experience I have when I'm talking to a real human is nearly identical to when I hear my playback of my own voice after I've mixed through Rupert Neve's stuff. And that is a clever feat that Mr. Neve has done for us. And that is precisely why I use Rupert Neve gear, because I'm trying to affect people emotionally. I'm an emotional illusionist, so I'm trying to make you believe the characters I do are real. And if they don't sound real, my performance is gonna be hampered. I know that of all the gear I've tested, and I've been doing this 25 years, and I know a little bit about sound, to my ear, when I play back my auditions, after I've mixed them on Rupert Neve stuff, all of a sudden I get a smile on my face and I'm like, it's alive. I mean, it's art and science, but all of it feeds into the human experience, you know, and that's why I love Rupert Neve's gear, because it's analog, it sounds like life, it's alive, it's hard to make anything sound bad with it, and it doesn't break.
All right, we're totally flat here. Let's check out the gain. I could probably gain up a little bit, but you can see at a glance, it's pretty quick. Like, if any of this was engaged, you'd see a big green light. None of it's engaged. No silk, no EQ, no compressor, no high-pass filter, and we're not phase inverting. So this is gonna be flat.
So this voice I'm gonna do is a very low guttural monster voice that I used on Shadow the Hedgehog. It's very similar to a voice I used on Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles called Shokunabo or Black Doom in Shadow the Hedgehog. And it's a subharmonic low voice that I use proximity effect on to emphasize the low frequency. So I'm gonna get very close to the mic, which is not a normal mic technique for regular voiceover. So that as you get close to the mic, most microphones will have an emphasis on the lower frequencies, which I'm gonna want for this voice. And then when we get to the Newton channel, you'll see how I'll play with those low frequencies to really make this creature sound like it's coming not out of a 5'10" guy, which is me, that it's coming out of a 6 or 7 foot hulking monster. And so here we go.
Disclose to me the location of the Ninja Turtles. What? What? No!
And I'm doing all that vocally spitty stuff for Vex, because sometimes they'll ask you in an audition, do some screaming, do some dying. Like, they might ask me, do a death knell for this character, and I might go, and what's really cool is when we get there with the Newton channel, all that spit and guttural stuff is going to sound really cool when we hit the compressor and the red silk circuit especially. Okay, cool. Now we're going to mix what we just recorded. Now, you could send it like this and it'll sound good. I'll be honest with you. Like, you don't have to do this, but if you want to make it sound really good, you start twisting knobs. First thing I'm going to do, actually,
disclose to me the location.
I'm
going to
get some general compression going. So let me look at my meters. I'm gonna do semi-fast. I'm gonna get it kind of fast.
Disclose to me the location of the Ninja Turtles.
All right, so what I've done here is I'm using a decent, I'm bringing my threshold down. I'm using almost negative 10 dB.
Disclose to me the location of the Ninja Turtles.
And I've got this compressor pre-EQ. So now I wanna get rid of a little bit of my mid.
Disclose to me the location.
But I'm gonna make up
with this.
Disclose to me the location of the Ninja Turtles.
Now, that's fundamentally where I want it. That's not bad. And the reason I didn't have to move the knobs that much is because it sounds so good from the get-go. It sounds so good. So now I'm going to hit my silk circuit. And now you can hear a big difference when I... Because what's happened is I've compressed it and I'm really pushing up the volume on this to get the most amount of volume and compression I can so that it's very, very clear so that when you send your audition, you're like, there it is. And so now I've hit the silk circuit.
Disclose to me the location of the Ninja Turtles. What? What? No!
And so basically I've done about 10 dB of reduction. I've sweetened the EQ. I've added my silk circuit and now it's really popping. And let's just play it back.
Disclose to me the location of the Ninja Turtles. What? What? No!
And there you go. And that's how I do pretty much every audition, either using my Shelford as a pre in the 5051 or 5052. I'll be honest, I don't currently own a Newton. They sent me one for review because I already have a Shelford channel in the 5051 and 5052. But if I had to sell those and stick with just one that gave me all the stuff, I'd probably just get a Newton. But I really like my Shelford and my other modules really a lot. So I'll probably keep using those. But for those of you who want, and by the way, a real important point, if you're interested in one of these, the Newton is significantly less expensive than the Shelford, almost half price to get fundamentally a very, very similar experience. And this part is really important because my belief, my philosophy as a voice actor is you need to know your whole job, soup to nuts. You need to know engineering, you need to know sound, you need to know harmonics, you need to know everything. Can you be a great voice actor without that? Sure, I know a bunch of great voice actors who know none of this shit, but I think it makes you more effective and more holistic. And there are times in a session where I've been able to help out because I've got good audio knowledge, you know, every once in a while. It's just another edge, another tool in your tool chest to make yourself competitive in the world of voiceover and to put your best foot forward. And if you're gonna be a pro, you buy the best. I buy the best. It's Rupert Neve Designs, and that's what I buy, and that's what I use.